Hi, welcome to Rides with Chuck. I just did a YouTube search of the 1926 Wills Sainte Claire automobile, and as of August 4th, 2010, this is the first video featuring the 1926 Wills Sainte Claire automobile. How has this car been overlooked?
This is a 1926 Wills Sainte Claire. Wills was Henry Ford's chief engineer up until 1919. He helped develop the Model T and came up with the Ford script logo. And he was a metallurgist, which is why the Model T is so successful, because it's made of vanadium steel. He wanted to build a car 10 years ahead of his time. And the good news and the bad news is he did. This car has hydraulic brakes, an electric fuel pump, overhead cam engine, pressurized cooling system, molybdenum steel alloy and keel key components, all kinds of really neat technological things. The problem was the car then became very expensive. He wanted to compete with Buick at about the $2,000 price point, and this car was $3,000. So now he was competing with Cadillac and Packard and Pierce Arrow. And this is not a flashy car. This is not a car that you drive to the country club and say, I've arrived. It's just a technical kind of interesting car. So the company was in business from 1921 to 1926. They made about 12,000 cars, and there are about 80 cars still in existence, and this is one of the last ones as a 26. The first cars had V8 engines that are overhead cam, and the later cars had sixes. That was partially due to cost and a lot due to complaints from mechanics of being hard to work on the V8.
You know the history of this car?
This car was a parts car. There was a gentleman that bought a used four-door sedan around 1930, after the company was out of business, and drove that car until 1956. Somewhere along the way, he had engine trouble, so he bought this car for parts. So this car's engine went into the other car, and other parts were taken off this car over the years to keep that car running. And both cars still exist, and both cars still have each other's engines in them. And a lot of parts were fabricated for this car when it was restored, because being a parts car, people were going to take off what they needed. But the reason it survived the World War II scrap drives, because there's lots of aluminum in the body and so on, is that it was still being actively used to keep another car running. This is a five-passenger sedan, or sometimes called a club sedan or close-coupled sedan, so there's no jump seats. So this would be like a family sedan. Plenty of room in the back seat. And the front, a little narrower, as all these cars are, because the bodies are tapered from front to back. The full complement of gauges on the dash. The two levers on the steering wheel are, one is for bright and dim on the headlights, and the other one is a throttle control when you're heating the car up when it's cold. It has a automatic advance on the distributor, so you don't need to have a spark control, which still existed on some cars in this period. Again, part of the advanced technology view of life. The overhead cam engine, which you're looking at, is shaft driven. It's modeled after Hispano Suiza aircraft engines. There's spiral bevel gears in this housing here and in the bottom of the crankcase. The Wills had a patent for thermal expansion to keep the cam lined up properly. There's some device on the end of the cam that compensates for temperature. The carburetor's original, but the little pressure regulating device in front of it is not. That would have been an electric fuel pump when the car was new. This was the first company to use electric fuel pumps starting in 1924. But modern electric fuel pumps have too much pressure, so you have to regulate the pressure down. So I just put that in place of the original fuel pump.
Is that a bell?
The bell is actually where you fill the oil. And it's also the vent for the crankcase. You'll notice it's much bigger in diameter than that. So when you get the gases in the crankcase, they flow out of there.
Well, I'm glad I asked, because I was leaving thinking that was a bell. Hey, what are your plans for this car in the future?
I'm going to drive it. It's an older restoration. It needs a million little things, or it needs nothing. It's a point of view thing. It's not a show car. It's meant to have fun and talk about the history.
Thanks for talking to us, Tom.
Thank you.